Come on, say bless me. Say it like you mean it. Say bless me. Say it like you mean it. Say bless me. We told them to pour it out upon me. Pour it out upon me, God. Pour your blessings out upon me, God. I need a blessing, God. I need a blessing. I need a blessing. He said, break me, make me, shake me, mold me. I need a blessing. But in order for the blessing to come, some things got to be broken. I was thinking about the lifespan of a chicken that a chicken have given the egg. But if the egg don't fight to come out of the shell, see, some of y'all blessings, you got to fight to come out of the shell. You're already blessed on the inside, but you got to fight to come out of the shell. Life is in the fight. Come on, don't stop fighting. Don't stop fighting. Don't stop fighting. He said, continue for the faith. Don't stop fighting. Don't stop fighting. I'm telling you the blessings of the Lord. They say they're rich and added no sorrow to them. I don't know if you know how blessed you are. Listen to me. You are blessed. Listen to me. You are walking in the blessings of God. You are the recipient of the blessings of God. You are that. The blessing is the belief is in the presence. Come on, somebody. I'm calling my inheritance in. All that my mama didn't get, all that my dad didn't get, all that my uncles didn't get, all that my sisters and brothers don't get, I'm calling my blessings in. I said, Lord, come see about it. Can you imagine? All you got to do is make up your mind. And when you make up your mind, you got to start declaring, I know I'm walking in the blessings of God. I'm telling you, healing is ours, deliverance is ours. I just believe I came over here to see my one and only uncle. Oh, God, no more uncles. Listen, unless they my make-believe uncles. But I was telling Pastor Crawford, I said, you know why I come over here? I said, because I want to see him and her. I'm telling you, all y'all is just the beneficiaries of what I want to see. I'm telling you, man, do you not know? Everything that come upon him, he fight it because he's contending for the faith. If he didn't have no faith, he'll be gone. But every time he get ready to go through it, look like they're trying to knock him down. He said, God, your word said. He said, God, your word said. He said, God, your word said, I should live and not die. I should declare the words of the Lord. Lord, your God, give him strength. I'm telling you. He sang a song years ago when he first started preaching. He said, I'm one of God's special men. Yes, I am. He chose me for the work I'm in. Yes, he did. Oh, I'm one of God's special. Every time I sing, he would sing that song. And guess what? I came by to tell you, my friend, God ain't forgot about you. He said he's getting up to pour out upon you. God, he must what I say. Even in deliverance is even yours. All over the body. We don't care what the doctors say. We know the healer. Did he do it before? He can do it again. Amen. Listen, I'm telling you. I don't know. Getting old ain't easy. It's tough. And if you're not tough when you get old, you're going to fold. I was in the Dominican Republic, 97 years old, Pastor Stevenson. A woman, she's 97 years old. She get up every morning, cook breakfast for all of her kids, still making dinner in a pot, a big old steel pot. And they making it with coals on the outside of the house. And she's stirring and things like that. You know what God told me to ask you? Do you still got a purpose? You should live. Come on, if you find the purpose, you're going to live. I'm telling you, if you find the purpose, you're going to live. You know why death can't take you? Because you still got purpose. I'm telling you, I got purpose. I'm telling you, I believe. And I'm going to live by faith. I'm clean. Amen. So I applaud Pastor Stevenson and the First Lady Stevenson and the Living Word family. I'm telling y'all are something. I don't know God is getting ready to do something that eyes haven't seen.
All right.
God is getting ready to do something that ears haven't heard. Neither have it entered into the heart of man what God got in store for you. Can I tell you what God just told me to tell you? He said, tell them they can really be blessed because of faithfulness. God gonna bless you because how many of y'all know you faithful? If you know you faithful, God is getting ready to bless you. I'm telling you. He said, I'm raining on the test right now. I'm gonna rain on you. Amen. So I'm gonna give it to who gave it back to me. Ella Love.